The views and opinions expressed on the following program are not necessarily those of the staff and management of KLAY or those who advertise their products or services on this station.
Cats and chicks, you're listening to Viva ENT. This is Johnny the Capo. We are on the air in Seattle, and I'm here with my co-host, Mr.
Brad Buckles. Good afternoon.
The greatest producer in all of the world.
Hey, it's Eric C.C. Ryder. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, guys. It's nice to be in the studio today. We got a great show. As always.
We got a rocking show.
I was
going
to say, you can feel the energy just kind of like coming right off the desk right now.
Very cool. I want to thank last week's guest, Paul Peterson. That was a great show, and it was a great interview. And Brad, I think you had a real good time with Paul yourself, yakking and stuff like that. He was, in his day, during his run during the Donna Reed show, when you walked into a store and you walked by the magazine rack,
mm-hmm.
his picture was on every teen magazine year after year after year. So he was a big deal.
I remember magazines.
Back in the day when
those still existed.
Yeah. They had those funny things in them called staples, too.
Right, right. No, yeah, he was a huge teen idol.
Yes, he was a huge teen idol. And
a few different hit records mm-hmm. as well as a singer and, mm-hmm. Very popular actor and activist now, I guess, as well.
I see.
He definitely plays that role. And it's interesting, too. It was, as he was discussing the stories and the experiences, it was fascinating me to find out, all the child actors that we've had that have come and gone, some good, some bad, he was just clean.
Yeah.
He lived his life, he had a great career, and he moved on, and he just has great stories.
That's right. He didn't have the scandal. He didn't rob a convenience store or get strung out on drugs or anything like that.
Egg his neighbors.
Which is why he's still going strong today, so good for him.
Of course, they didn't have social media, so maybe he did a few things that we don't know
well,
about.
Well, that's true. That is true.
There was no TMZ back then.
Oh,
yeah.
Boy.
I'm sure social media would have sunk many teen idol back in the day had it existed.
Social media would have sunk me and I wasn't even popular.
There you go.
Oh, you guys are cracking me up.
But what a fascinating guy. I mean, great career, music, TV, movies, all kinds of stuff. Just fascinating.
Yeah, he was in a movie with Sophia Loren. That alone right there makes me happy.
Pretty cool. And we've got another great guest lined up today as we continue our discussion about the golden age of rock and roll.
That is correct. We have Patty Anderson on, and she has been involved with Elvis Presley Enterprises for many, many years, and and she's going to be a fascinating guest. So Elvis,
she was in charge of the fan club, is what I understand.
Yeah.
Right? Fan clubs worldwide?
Worldwide, yeah.
The list of clients that she has on the website here is no small list. This is everybody.
You got a couple names?
I got a couple names. Like, I don't know, Merv Griffin.
Cool.
Motley Crue. John Bon Jovi.
Oh, yeah.
The Osmonds. Joan Rivers. Steven Tyler. Mm-hmm. All over the decades.
Yeah, and I'm going to Graceland myself in August, man.
Well, and speaking of fan clubs, I can't think of a bigger Elvis Presley fan than you, Johnny. Maybe. Were you ever in the official fan club?
I never have been.
Oh,
what? No, wait a second. How does that work?
That's surprising to me.
I don't know. It just never happened, but.
Do you ever think about it?
Occasionally.
I don't know that I've ever been in a fan club of a particular artist, but I know those days were huge at one time.
Yeah, I knew a guy in Vegas that was the president of the Las Vegas Presley fan club. And that was probably the closest I ever got to joining, but I never did join. But I would, and I'm open to the idea.
Hey, to know like no time like today. Open that phone.
Maybe.
Speaking of social media, I mean, fan clubs used to be quite a phenomenon. It used to be the social media of its time. I mean, I don't think people join fan clubs because they just follow their favorite artists on Twitter or Facebook or whatever.
They have fan pages.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Groups.
Right, and groups that discuss. But it's, you know, it used to be like something official that artists set up or like a group of fans would set up, and they would send out like special editions of records and stuff for the hardcore fans.
Right.
Sure. I don't know if that really exists today, at least not on the same level that it existed back in the 50s and 60s.
Well, I bet you our guest today can fill us in a little bit about that.
I'll bet she can.
Yeah.
Very cool. Well, we're looking forward to that.
Yeah, we're looking forward to talking to her. And, of course, Jerry Osborne will be here next week, ladies and gentlemen. We have Larry Thomas, the soup Nazi from Seinfeld, on our show. Viva ENT.
Did you watch over the weekend this 90th anniversary where they were talking about the station and all the various different actors and actresses that have come through the 90th celebration?
No, I didn't.
90th celebration of what?
NBC.
Oh,
they had
Kelsey
Grammer.
NBC.
Yeah. Oh, I missed that.
Kelsey Grammer Sunday night came out and talked about how it started and what it meant to be a part of this great corporation, this movement, and how if you were on that particular network, you were the A-list, man. It was it. And the soup Nazi was definitely one of the specific personalities that they credited. You know, each decade there was one or two things that really stood out.
Right, right.
And they were attributing the soup Nazi to something very fantastic during that time.
Sure. I mean, that was definitely a memorable Seinfeld episode.
Absolutely.
For sure, so.
Yeah,
and he's done a lot of other great work, so looking forward to hearing his stories. I'm actually reading a book right now called Seinfeldia. That's all about, you know, how the show came about, because I'm a big Seinfeld fan, so this is going to be pretty cool to talk to him.
Likewise. I love that new show that he does with writing with
Cars.
Yeah,
comedians in cars getting coffee.
That is a phenomenal show.
It is. It is. He's a great communicator and a great talent. There's no question about it.
Yep.
No question. So before our guest comes on, in about 8 minutes or so, let's talk a little bit about Tacoma Wedding Expo coming up in March at the Tacoma Dome, Brad.
You know, we've got a really big show in line. We're up about 15% over last year's show, which is just fun. It's a lot of new vendors. We have Igloo Rolls, which is a company that comes in and makes rolled ice cream to your flavor, rolls it up kind of like an ice cream roll sandwich type thing.
Like a tamale?
Well, yeah, with ice cream, yeah. But they make it all live right there, and then they serve it to you for your particular color, flavor, you know, whatever you like.
Cool.
And they make it live and serve it to you right there at your event.
That is marvelous. I'm looking forward to seeing that.
Yep, that's fun. And then we've got, who else do we have? Talking Rain's a big sponsor. You can come in and get all the new flavors and the various different drinks.
I love Talking Rain.
All kinds of new companies that are coming out in the event industry. As the economy's gotten a little bit stronger and a little bit more fun, there's all kinds of new things that are starting to pop up at Christmas parties and weddings and corporate picnics. You see a lot of these fun things. You know, food trucks are huge.
Yes, they are. As a matter of fact, I'm working with at an event at my new venue in Edmonds. It's the old Edmonds Opera House and Masonic Hall, which, ladies and gentlemen, you can call me to book that room, 206-542-5733. And same thing, exactly what you're talking about.
Yep. I was just calling my attorney because we wanted to get together. We get together for lunch about once a month, and he was like, hey, let's go do food trucks tomorrow.
Yeah.
And I said, what exactly do you mean? He goes, well, just outside of my office here, there's four or five food trucks that pull up.
Yeah.
Let's go do a food truck sampling.
Cool.
So tomorrow we're going to go eat food trucks.
Yeah, they're going to have I just booked an event for October, and they're going to bring in a taco truck, you know, and everybody will go outside, go to the truck and get the food and come back in. Hey.
Yep.
Whatever works, you know.
Well, this company called Igloo Rolls does the exact same thing, but with ice cream.
Very cool. Now, is there any opportunity for vendors to still get into the show?
We do. We have about 15 spaces left, which in the next month they'll go fast. But
an interesting story about, so vendors, if any vendors are out there listening, I just booked a client for the Preston Community Center, which is in the Snoqualmie area. Mm-hmm. I think you've actually been there a couple of times. And they met me at the Tacoma show. So you wouldn't think that, you know, just because it's Tacoma doesn't mean that you're not going to book weddings up north or in Seattle.
Sure.
Or even northern, you know. As a matter of fact, I met someone at the Tacoma Wedding Expo that was actually having an event, a wedding at Camino Island.
Yeah, I just talked to a photographer the other day who said they got booked by a bride who came to the Tacoma Dome show that flew them to Italy to shoot their wedding.
Yeah, that can't happen to me. I mean, I like it to happen to me, but gosh, what luck that is. Huh?
Yep, they were talking back and forth, and she goes, well, I just have one question. Would you be willing to go to Italy with me if I buy you a ticket?
Holy mackerel.
I don't think the photographer answered fast enough.
So we're getting ready to go to hear a word from our sponsors pretty quick, and we're going to talk about the trivia at the Issaquah Ram, soon coming to the Marysville Ram. We're going to talk about the Viva Diva Flea Market on after our guest comes on. And we're going to talk a little bit about Brian Wilson. All kinds of interesting topics coming up.
And our guest today is Patsy Anderson.
Patsy Anderson.
That's right.
And she'll be on after we go to break, ladies and gentlemen.
You're listening to Viva ENT. Everybody stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Thank you so much.
Attention business owners. Experience a new world of business with barter. The Saturn Barter Company, located in Tacoma, is one of the most beneficial business decisions you can make. Using Saturn Barter, you are able to sell your products or services to other members of the exchange. You can then use that credit you've built up from your sales to purchase the products or services you or your company needs from other companies within Saturn Barter, all without the use of cash. Contact and join Saturn Barter Club today, 253-212-9999. Or online at SaturnBarter.com.
Dr. Amanda Wong and the team at Art of the Smiles provides comprehensive dental services at affordable prices. Their convenient location in Federal Way and their extended hours fits the needs of both families and working professionals. Whether it's transforming your smile through some of their cosmetic therapies or simply having your teeth cleaned, Art of the Smiles provides individualized care plans that address your priorities and needs. Visit ArtOfTheSmiles.com or call 253-839-4048. That's 253-839-4048 for same-day scheduling. Most insurances accepted, from cosmetic procedures to implant placement, molar root canals treatment, or wisdom teeth extractions.
This is Johnny the Gangster with Viva Productions, King of Entertainment, one-stop shop for all your entertainment needs. We have DJ service for weddings, corporate, and private events. Throw your guests with Vegas Nights Casino Party, Blackjack, Craps, Roulette, Poker, and more. We also have event photography and limousine service. Call Viva Productions, 206-542-5733, or find us at viva-productions.com. A little less conversation, a little more action, you got it. Call Johnny the Gangster, I'll make you a deal you can't refuse.
Brides, do you want your big day to be stress-free, perfect, and stay within your budget? Well, Brides Club has all the inside information to make your dream a reality. Go to BridesClub.com. That's BridesClub.com. See upcoming bridal shows and events, view wedding vendors and special offers. And don't miss The Spotlight, the premier online wedding magazine with valuable articles you can't afford to miss. Brides Club helps make your wedding stress-free and perfect. Go to BridesClub.com. Check out BridesClub.com.
Is your vehicle needing some attention? Take it over to Maddie's Tuning and Shoreline for fast, affordable car care. Trusted, professional, Maddie's services all makes and models and has been trusted in the Puget Sound for almost 60 years. Call Brian Maddie at 206-364-3347 or stop by his convenient location in Shoreline right on Aurora at 152nd. Maddie's Tuning. Call 206-364-3347. 3347. Trusted for almost 60 years to keep you safe and on the road.
Life's a celebration. Grand Event Rentals makes your event their top priority. They are your full-service special event and party rental provider, supplying everything you need from start to finish. Their professional sales team and event staff work with you to create your dream event. With every event, Grand Event Rentals customers' needs are the most important. Whether you're planning an intimate outdoor wedding or an elaborate black tie gala, the Grand Event Rental Specialists make great pride in providing our event planning experience to help create an unforgettable event. Please go and visit the Bellevue Showroom, Grand Event Rentals, or make a one-on-one appointment. Talk to them. They're trained. They're knowledgeable. They're event specialists, and they are going to take you through step-by-step everything that you need to make your day a success. Call Grand Event Rentals. Their number is 425-462-7368, or go to grandeventrentalswa.com.
Clay Radio, your conversation station. KLAY Lakewood Tacoma on 1180 AM.
A little less conversation, a little more action. All this aggravation ain't satisfaction in me. A little more bite and a little less spark. A little less fight and a little more spark. Close your mouth and open up your heart and if it's satisfied.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are listening to Viva ENT. We are in the studio with my co-host, Mr.
Brad Buckles.
Excellent producer, Mr.
It's Eric C.C. Reiner.
I got our talent coordinator, Jerry Osborne, the line with our great guest today, Patsy Anderson. And so, Elvis fans, this is going to be a treat today because we're talking Elvis for the next half hour. And Patsy or Jerry, bring on Patsy.
Well, I'm just along for the ride, but I would like Patsy to begin. For those of you who don't know her as well as I do, hint, hint, but how did you get involved in all of this in the first place? You didn't just walk into Graceland one day and they said, hey, let's put you in charge of fan clubs worldwide. This had to begin with you perhaps maybe starting as a tour guide or maybe just starting as a customer. So explain the whole thing.
Actually, I did just kind of walk in, and it was very interesting. I actually walked in, and I actually began, they hired me to work in the office.
Mm-hmm.
So I worked in the office for several months. And then we opened Graceland to the public, and they wanted me to stay in the office, but I you know me, Jerry, I had to preach the gospel of Elvis. That was my calling.
Cool.
So I actually wanted to be a tour guide. So I tour guided for several years, and then our CEO Jack Stone, he was reorganizing everything, and asked that Todd Morgan and myself take over the communications department, and we started doing marketing and the media, and it just kind of snowballed from there, and it was awesome. It was a wonderful, wonderful time, and I'm very grateful for it. It was great.
Yeah, you know, I can appreciate what you're saying because, you know, I talk Elvis all the time. I'm converting people that don't really know much about him, and I'm exposing them, you know, to the music, and I wouldn't mind having that job.
it was really fun, and then I also, you know, got to work with Priscilla, and it was Lisa, but a lot with Priscilla, and in fact, I was her double when we were doing the film project.
Wow!
And I worked right alongside of her, and yeah, we became really good friends.
Was that the Elvis and Me miniseries?
With all of the Elvis and Me and all of the, you know, America Comes to Graceland, except, let me see, that was Lisa Hartman Black, and I was her double as well.
Cool.
But anyway, we did and all of the other projects, I can't recall all of them right this moment, but the ones where we had, you know, we were promoting Elvis and with the film, et cetera, and Elvis the TV series, I worked with that.
Very
so it
cool.
was, yeah, it was a lot of fun. I had a great time. Man, needless to say,
I couldn't think of a better job to go in every day and talk about the king.
Exactly, it is and you found out so many really neat things about Elvis that, you know, as you're a fan, which you and I, and I'm a huge fan as well, always have been, and anyway, you think you know all of this, and then you get in there, and you. You get into the places of the home that no one's been,
right.
And you get to see all the records and all the contracts and all of the notes. And it's amazing, and you just kind of sit back and kind of pinch yourself, and you know, because the man was so generous. We had Sidney Pollack come through Graceland, and when he was on his heyday for, you know, the Hollywood producer, And he was so impressed. We had an exhibit there that we had put all of the charities that Elvis had donated to during his lifetime. Now, what people probably don't know is that all the charities that he supported, he did not use it as a tax deduction.
No kidding.
No, he did not, even though the CPAs begged him to, because he really needed the deductions, and they begged him to, but he would not. His philosophy was that if it didn't hurt him a little bit to give, then you know, if it just helped him, he was not doing what he should be doing as far as charity.
Yeah.
That it, you know, and so, and he was just mesmerized by that, and all of the different organizations that Elvis had supported, and he was. Most people were are very, very shocked with all of the gold and platinum records. It's just unbelievable. But Sidney was more impressed with the giving of Elvis, and it's really a cool thing. He was generous beyond belief.
Correct.
And had a really, really good, loving, caring heart.
No question about that. You know, there's just so many stories. You know, during his lifetime, about him giving Cadillacs to complete strangers. There was a story about him buying a limousine for a guy that was driving a limo one night for him.
Yeah.
And just, and all the gifts that he gave to his friends, guys that were in the Memphis Mafia, so on and so forth. So, no question about his generosity.
Well, he gave me one of those cheap little necklaces that you see around a lot.
No kidding.
Yeah, Patsy, you know.
TCB?
Yeah.
No kidding.
Oh, yeah. Okay, Patsy, one thing that I can't let you get away without talking about, because to me it was one of the highlights of the entire year, and that was those incredible fan club president dinners and events that you put on, and you had all the guests from the Elvis world. In fact, I was a guest quite a few times, as you might recall. But
yes,
we just had such a great time, and I know that had to have been one of the thrills of your annual life.
I loved it. We started planning our, I would do January and also one in August. And it was basically our way of thanking the fan club presidents because, as you know, they work very, very hard. They work very hard, and they don't get paid for it. And a lot of times they are actually taking the monies out of their own pockets, you know, to do their events and to raise, and they raise it. Raised a ton of money for charities. They all select a charity and work with that charity. And their motto is picking up where Elvis left off, which is awesome.
Cool.
But I had such great times with that. And I think probably one of my favorite ones was actually the last one I did, which was the Fans Choice Award. And we did that at the Grand Casino in Tunica, Mississippi. And the fans all voted on their favorite movie character, their favorite co-star, their favorite female co-star, their favorite song. They voted on all of this. It was kind of like the Academy Awards, and it was just so fun because we had Anne Margaret represent. Anne couldn't come in live; she was doing an opening at one of the casinos on that day, and so I went to her. And took a film crew.
Cool.
And presented the award because she was the favorite female co-star, needless to say.
Yeah, I can see that for sure.
Oh yeah, she's absolutely remarkable. What a great lady! And I must tell you what she said.
Please.
I had Roger Smith is her husband, and we had been working together, but I had not met Annie as of yet. So I went into the penthouse and. And Roger was there. We were talking, and he said, "Amy will be right out. It's okay." So she came out, and I was so thrilled to meet her. And I held in my hand, and I said, "Annie is such a delight to meet you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just thrilled to death." And I said, "I'm Patsy Anderson," and she looked at me and she said, "The Patsy Anderson?" And I looked at her and I said, "Well, it's according to what you've heard. Maybe I know her just really well."
Wow.
So, but I just couldn't believe she said that. It was just but she's what a sweetheart. What a sweetheart. And she and Roger both great people.
Yeah,
but I think
Go ahead.
You know, I think that has to be one. I think that has to be one of my favorites because we had live music. I mean, everybody was there. The Jordanaires, Joe Esposito was a presenter. All of the guys were presenters, and we had everybody receiving their awards from all the movies that Elvis had done.
Well, my favorite three top female movie stars of all time are Marilyn Monroe, Sophia Loren, and Anne Margaret.
Yeah.
So she was, you know, she really didn't get the credit she deserved, really. I mean, she has, but just like Elvis, I don't feel like Elvis was critically acclaimed as much as he should have been for his artistry, especially in the studio when he was recording.
Yeah. Oh, I think you're so right, and I think even in the movies. I mean, Walter Matthau told us that he was an instinctive actor.
Yes, he was.
You know, he would come on the set, not only know his lines, but get everybody else's lines memorized as well.
Yeah, he should have got some of those roles in the 60s, like maybe like in The Hustler that Paul Newman got, and maybe even Dirty Harry. He'd have been he'd have been great in all those movies, really.
He was, you know, he was offered several, but unfortunately the Colonel turned him down. So
I know.
You know, he was an excellent actor, no doubt about it.
You know, a bit of a curse was Blue Hawaii because Blue Hawaii was such a smash success that, Elvis kind of like just went with the flow, you know. So it was great and it wasn't.
I think unfortunately with Hollywood they find a success and they stick with it because it's like okay, this is a success, so.
Yeah.
This is what we're going to stay into. I think Elvis really wanted to break out of the role and really do some very dramatic scenes. Awesome.
He tried to do that after G.I. Blues. You know, he insisted on a couple of movies where he didn't really have to sing. And so he got Flaming Star and Wild in the Country, which only had a few songs. And then along came Blue Hawaii. So then after that, it was like...
It was done.
Mm-hmm.
All right, my trivia experts.
Yes, dear.
What? Very, very famous singing star had an uncredited role and appearance in Blue Hawaii.
Oh, my gosh, was it?
One of the top female singers of all time.
No kidding.
Yeah. I wouldn't have thought of this if you hadn't started talking about Blue Hawaii.
Well, you're getting me on this one, a female vocalist?
I'm trying to think about it. Let me see.
One that everyone knows.
Oh, my gosh. And would she have a cameo or is she just...
Yes. A non-speaking part.
So she was just in a scene and she was... Wow.
Yes. And the reason is because her husband was on the production crew.
Oh, could have been a Nancy Sinatra?
No. I'll tell you, otherwise we'll just sit here waiting for you to come up with something.
Go ahead.
Patty Page.
Patty Page, oh yeah.
Patty Page is sitting in the canoe floating down the river near the end of the show where he's battling back and forth with his girlfriend in the little hut. But anyway, she's in the canoe, and you can't even see her that well because the camera's not really focusing on her. But anyway, I thought it was a neat piece of trivia that you should know about.
Yeah,
that's amazing.
I
don't remember that. I don't remember seeing her. So, but that's interesting, absolutely. And can you tell me? Let me see which movie Ozzy Osbourne was in.
Oh, no, I don't know that.
A Presley movie?
A Presley movie?
No. Is that the question?
She's about ready to teach you something, Mr. Elvis Presley.
Yeah. He was one of the cliff divers in Fun in Acapulco.
No kidding.
Wow.
Didn't know that.
I did not know that, but that's going to be repeated here very shortly.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, he was one of the cliff divers. And then Raquel Welch was in one as well.
Yeah, Raquel was in Rastabout.
That was Rastabout with it. So, there's a lot of little stars that walked through. For a second or so.
Yeah, I think Raquel Welch's very first movie appearance was in Rastabout.
You're absolutely right.
Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that is true. Patsy, what have you done since you left Graceland?
Oh, my gosh. I am so busy. And, so I've got my own production company. And because, as you know, I love production. Love it, love it, love it. Especially with special effects. I love that. And so anyway, right at this moment, I'm really super busy. Johnny Moore's family has asked me to do a memorial tribute to him. And so I'm trying to get all that together for August.
Cool.
And we're going to have some really, really neat entertainers there. And hopefully we're going to do Scotty justice. And because he was, Scotty was just remarkable. Yeah. What a remarkable human being he was.
Oh, we had him at our events many times, as you know.
Yeah, and a dear, dear friend, dear friend. And he was just, we'd miss him every day. And but anyway, I'm working on that. And then also we're doing some events over at the Fox and Hound restaurant with them and making a really big week out of it for the fans. And what I love about this is that we've got some great things happening. We're doing some book signings with all of those who are close to Elvis and family of Elvis's. And then we're also having some ETAs perform after the book signing. And what I like most of all about it, though, Jerry, is it's free. It's all free.
Cool.
The fans can come and enjoy the shows and meet all those that have written books on Elvis and then have something great to eat. And, you know, it's going to be a really fun day. And I love it because it's free.
Yeah.
And we're putting it together.
Sounds wonderful and marvelous. You know, we were talking earlier about the fan clubs and, you know, you being such a big part of the fan clubs and stuff. Are fan clubs kind of fading out because of social media?
They, when I left Graceland, that we had 641 fan clubs. They have now waned to just a few over 200, and it breaks my heart because it's a great. I mean, for those who are in that certain area, it's the way to get together, and everyone becomes family.
Yeah.
I was talking one time to Millie Kirkham. And, you know, she was with Elvis and doing the high part, the beautiful high voice.
Yeah.
Before Kathy came on. And anyway, I told her, I said, you know, who would have ever thought that we would all become family? A lot of us sat in those auditoriums and, you know, watching Elvis perform and did not know who was in front of us or who was beside of us. But now we all know everyone. I mean, we're all like a family.
Yeah.
And Jerry Schilling one time told me, he said, if Elvis could have ever chosen how he was going to be remembered, this is the way he would have wanted it. And I agree with that. But the clubs just do, I mean, they raise funds for, you know, for the charities, and they donate, and they work with, you know, all sorts of children's organizations, and yeah, it's just amazing. They're absolutely such good people, and they work really hard, and it's all for the, you know, legacy of Elvis Presley.
No, wonderful, absolutely wonderful.
He would be amazed.
Patsy, if all goes well, Johnny will be along with us this year in Memphis.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
I've already got my plane ticket.
Well, now make sure you get your running shoes.
Oh, okay.
Because you don't sleep ever.
Yeah, I imagine.
There's no sleep. It's just run.
Yeah, I'm gonna be there 4 or 5 days from Sunday to Wednesday ish during that week. I'm not gonna be out there on the 16th, but
yeah,
I think so I'll get a chance to meet you then, huh?
Yes, absolutely.
That's true.
Be there. Yes.
And maybe we can get Johnny a gig at the tent because he does do the act.
Yes, I can.
Well, wonderful. That sounds great.
Yeah, give me a gig at the tent. I'll be happy to perform.
Yeah, we will put you on there because I have to be friends with a good guy that has that.
Well, sign me up, Johnny the Capo.
Johnny and the Bad Boys.
Yeah. Probably just me without the Bad Boys.
Okay, Patsy, what's your favorite Elvis song, or just name one in particular?
Oh, my gosh. You know, how can you do that?
No, anyone will do.
Almost impossible.
You know, and this, my favorite has always been Hurt, but I've got to explain this to you, because, you know, it was just all over the musical chart. I mean, he could just hit everything on it. And he recorded it at Graceland,
mm-hmm.
You know, and however, it only went to number 28 on the chart. And it remained there for, I think it was 11 weeks, I think it was. But yet in his concert, it was always a huge showstopper. I mean, he could have gone to number one. But one of my dearest favorite ones is that This Is Our Dance. I don't think it even charted, but it's just such a gorgeous song.
What song again was that, did you say?
This Is Our Dance.
Oh, yeah, Our Dance.
Yeah, it was an album cut, I believe.
Yeah, This Is Our Dance. So it's just an incredible song. I asked one of the guys inside, Danny McCorkle, I said, do you know This Is Our Dance? And he said, absolutely. He said, and he put it on. Mm-hmm. And everyone got up and started dancing. I mean, all the husbands and wives and couples began to dance. And I just thought, this is really cool.
Very cool.
It's not well known amongst everybody.
It is among the Elvis world. But you know, when that came out, it reminded me very much of The Last Waltz by Engelbert Humperdinck.
Right.
Can you make that connection?
It does. Yes, I made the same connection. Absolutely. Yeah. So it was, but it's just such a great song, and it's just such a love song. I just think it's wonderful.
Yeah.
And,
was that from the Elvis Presley Boulevard album?
No. No, it was one that he did with the Stamps off maybe Today or Promised Land or one of those.
Oh, okay, cool. Very cool.
I could have told you immediately, but I've forgotten now. So
it's okay.
You know, it's where that, it's not age. It's not age.
Okay, Johnny, so pick an Elvis song and sing a line or two to Patsy, because I want her to be entertained by you here.
Well, I'm not in a very good voice today. I've got a bit of a sore throat, but...
Hey, that didn't keep Elvis from going on stage. Suck it up, man.
Okay. Well, here you go. I'm going to get a little sip here, and I'm going to do it. Of course, I really hate to sing when I'm not in good voice. But here you go. Are you lonesome tonight? Do you miss me tonight? Are you sorry we drifted apart? And that's on a sore throat.
There you go.
Lordy, are you married? Would you like to be?
Yes, and who knows?
Answer would be no and no.
When I come to Graceland, I'll be in good voice and I'll sing for you very nice.
Oh, you sound awesome. With a sore throat, I'm impressed.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much.
It was just, but a little bit more about the fan clubs also. You know, they started the Candlelight Vigil.
Right.
You know, in 78, they started it. And I think a few, in fact, Jerry, you may know, didn't a few of them even in 77 after Elvis passed away? I know they came up to the fence there. Didn't they put some candles on at that time? I believe they did. That it started right after he passed away.
I can't believe the number of people that walked through the gates of Graceland on that day in the year.
Didn't that kind of get started with the Elvis Country Fan Club?
Yes, it was. George Ann Reynolds. Yes, she started. She was president of the club and this held it on, and now, you know, all the clubs now are represented. They do the honor guard, and they stand on the driveway. And so they trade off with Elvis Country, and then the other honor guard are presidents of other clubs. And, it's really cool.
Patsy, we're down to about 2 minutes here. Can you tell our listeners about your website, your Facebook, or anything that you got going?
My Facebook is Patsy Anderson Presley, I've got Patsy Anderson Presley Productions, which is my website.
Cool.
And so we try to, keep everything up to date. And I'm still trying to kind of keep the fan clubs organized and give them, we do little excerpts on a daily basis, kind of what Elvis was doing just fun little things about J.D. Sumner and the Stamps and the TCB band and things of that nature. And kind of carry it over to the website as well. So. Everyone come and look and correspond with me. I'd love to hear from everyone.
Well, I can't wait to meet you in August of this year, and it's been a pleasure to have you on our show.
Oh, thanks, guys. It's been awesome. Johnny, great to talk with you. Brad, wherever Brad is.
I'm right here.
Oh, okay.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. My love, Jerry.
Oh, you're just so wonderful.
Oh, yeah, listen, can I tell them, just have a minute to tell them that the note on my door of my office?
I think you should.
Okay. I had to laugh because I was out, it was during Elvis week, and I came back in the office, and on my door was this post-it note, and it said, "I was here and you were there. Now I am there and you are here. Signed, Love, Jerry."
No. I was there and you were gone. Now you are here and I am gone.
Oh, okay. I got it wrong. I've always repeated it the other way.
Well, you know, I wrote it, so I should know.
You should know. You wrote it.
Some things we just never forget.
That's true. It was very well done. We've laughed over that for many years.
Wow.
Patsy, I'm going to call you back in a little while or within the next day or two. I got a few things I want to talk to you about, but nothing to do with the radio show. So we'll get together soon.
All right, honey. Sounds great. Thanks, guys. It's been great talking with you.
Thanks, Patsy. Thank you so much.
Bye-bye.
Thanks, everyone.
Bye-bye.
See you in August.
Okay, I'll be there. That's kind of cool, talking to somebody that you're going to meet.
Okay.
Later.
Well, see, I thought you would enjoy that.
Yeah, that was a great guest to have on today. We haven't really done an Elvis thing for quite some time. All right, Jareth, we'll talk to you soon, and thank you very much.
Okay, guys, see you.
Okay, so we're going to have a word from our sponsors, ladies and gentlemen. That was a great interview with Patsy. And is this the song she was talking about?
This is our dance. Now all
our friends are leaving. Yes. It's a hidden treasure.
All right, everybody, stay tuned for more Viva ENT. We're coming right back.
Wait till everybody has gone, then play just one more song. Cause this is our dance. Darling, remember, it's our
Dr. Amanda Wong and the team at Art of the Smiles provides comprehensive dental services at affordable prices. Their convenient location in Federal Way and their extended hours fits the needs of both families and working professionals. Whether it's transforming your smile through some of their cosmetic therapies or simply having your teeth cleaned, Art of the Smiles provides individualized care plans that address your priorities and needs. Visit artofthesmiles.com or call 253-839-4048. That's 253-839-4048 for same-day scheduling. Most insurances accepted, from cosmetic procedures to implant placement, molar root canals treatment, or wisdom teeth extractions.
Life's a celebration. Grand Event Rentals makes your event their top priority. They're your full-service, special event, and party rental provider, supplying everything you need from start to finish. Their professional sales team and event staff work with you to create your dream event. With every event, Grand Event Rentals customers' needs are the most important. Whether you're planning an intimate outdoor wedding or an elaborate black tie gala, the Grand Event Rental specialists make great pride in providing our event planning experience to help create an unforgettable event. Please go and visit the Bellevue Showroom, Grand Event Rentals, or make a one-on-one appointment. Talk to them. They're trained, they're knowledgeable, they're event specialists, and they are going to take you through step-by-step everything that you need to make your day a success. Call Grand Event Rentals. Their number is 425-462-7368, or go to grandeventrentalswa.com.
Attention business owners. Experience a new world of business with Barter,
The Saturn Barter Company, located in Tacoma, is one of the most beneficial business decisions you can make. Using Saturn Barter, you are able to sell your products or services to other members of the exchange. You can then use that credit you've built up from your sales to purchase the products or services you or your company needs from other companies within Saturn Barter, all without the use of cash. Contact and join Saturn Barter Club today, 253-212-9930, or online at SaturnBarter.com.
This is Johnny the Gangster with Viva Productions, King of Entertainment, one-stop shop for all your entertainment needs. We have DJ service for weddings, corporate, and private events. Throw your guests with Vegas Nights Casino Party, Blackjack, Craps, Roulette, Poker, and more. We also have event photography and limousine service. Call Viva Productions, 206-542-5733, or find us at viva-productions.com. A little less conversation, a little more action, you got it. Call Johnny the Gangster, I'll make you a deal you can't refuse.
Brides, do you want your big day to be stress-free, perfect, and stay within your budget? Well, Brides Club has all the inside information to make your dream a reality. Go to bridesclub.com. That's bridesclub.com. See upcoming bridal shows and events, view wedding vendors and special offers. And don't miss The Spotlight, the premier online wedding magazine with valuable articles you can't afford to miss. Brides Club helps make your wedding stress-free and perfect. Go to bridesclub.com. Check out bridesclub.com.
Is your vehicle needing some attention? Take it over to Maddie's Tuning and Shoreline for fast, affordable car care. Trusted, professional, Maddie's services all makes and models and has been trusted in the Puget Sound for almost 60 years. Call Brian Maddie at 206-364-3347 or stop by his convenient location in Shoreline right on Aurora at 152nd. Maddie's Tuning. Call 206-364-3347. Trusted for almost 60 years to keep you safe and on the road.
You found us.
Clay Radio, your conversation station. KLAY Lakewood Tacoma on 1180 AM.
I'll never let you go now. You're here in my arms. And when I hear you whisper your mind, we'll play that song just one more time. 'Cause this is our dance, darling, remember it's our dance. Loving and tender, I'll take you away, take you away.
Ladies and gentlemen, you listen to Viva ENT. What a great, fascinating guest that was. Patsy Anderson, I want to thank her once again for being on the show, and we played a little snippet of one of her favorite songs there.
Yeah, Elvis Presley, This Is Our Dance.
This Is Our Dance.
Boy, I think she could have gone on all hour.
Yeah, she could have, actually.
I bet that one gets a lot of play at weddings.
You know, it should be, but...
I've never played it.
Yeah, I haven't either, but maybe...
Maybe one to add to the playlist.
Yeah, maybe I will. It's really kind of a good slow dance song.
I'm
going to
quote you on that.
Yeah. We'll play.
Pull it up at the next wedding and be like, according to Eric C.C. Ryder,
The Last Dance.
This is the song.
I want to talk a little bit about trivia night at the Issaquah Ram. I am there live, Johnny the Capo, every Wednesday at 9 p.m. at Issaquah Ram. We have a trivia show that we're doing, and I have a special section called Rock and Roll Trivia, which fits into right what we're doing here.
It does.
On the radio.
How often do people know most of the answers?
Well.
Or are you kind of hard on them?
I don't think I'm hard on them, but one of the questions was, pardon my voice, ladies and gentlemen, what was Elvis's first movie? And the choices were Love Me Tender, G.I. Blues, Viva Las Vegas, and King Creole or something. And hardly anybody got Love Me Tender. So that's kind of flippy. But and then also we're going to start doing the Marysville Ram shortly, in about a couple weeks, on Tuesday nights at 9. So I'm into the trivia thing now, and that's kind of cool. So everybody, Issaquah Ram tomorrow night, be there or be square. I have an interesting situation coming up on April 1st. It's called the Viva Diva Flea Market in Edmonds at the Edmonds Lodge.
I keep hearing about this.
It's going to be it's going to be our first one. It's going to be a monthly thing. The first one is April 1st, and then after that, it's going to be every Saturday, the third Saturday, pardon me, third Saturday of every month. I'm looking forward to producing it. We're going to have music, food, lots of interesting
stuff. You use the word flea
buy.
Market, but this is a lot more upscale than just a flea market.
That's correct. It's going to be antiques and collectibles. It's going to be a bunch of stuff. I'm going to, you know, probably feature some audio stuff that I have that I'm just not using anymore that maybe someone else can use it, you know. So
audio gear, you mean?
Audio gear, yeah. I got a ton of gear that's just sitting there, you know. Somebody should be using it.
Yeah? So it's much more upscale than just a flea market.
Right, and the venue is really a hidden treasure in Edmonds. It's known as the Edmonds Lodge. It's a Masonic hall, but it's a 3,600-square-foot ballroom, really. And so we're going to have the tables inside. It's going to be a nice because, you know, no matter what the weather is, we're happening, you know. So April 1st, I'd like you to come down if you're not doing nothing, Brad, and just come on down and have some fun. I'll feed you.
Well, you can't turn that down.
Absolutely.
Can't turn that down ever.
Absolutely not. So you've been, you just bought a book about Brian Wilson.
Oh, that was the thing, yeah. You know, of all the different interviews we've done over the last couple of years, Brian Wilson's name kind of keeps coming back up.
It does.
In fact, last week when we were talking to Paul Peterson.
Correct.
Brian Wilson had written him one of his first songs.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just interesting. I was down at one of the bookstores here recently, and I went through the music section, and here's all this information on all these variety of different people. And Brian Wilson just was like, buy me. So I bought it. It's a great book. And it's interesting, from all the different interviews we've done, how many different people seem to have had relationships with Brian Wilson?
Well, a lot. And, you know, and we're fortunate enough to have a lot of the people that were involved with the music business out of that LA scene. You know, and of course, that's exactly where Brian was. That was his headquarters, Capitol Records. And no question about his genius. And, you know, Paul McCartney and John Lennon, they adored Brian Wilson. And as a matter of fact, you know, when the Beatles were in their height of their popularity, when their albums were, you know, just great masterpieces, they were actually listening to Brian Wilson when Pet Sounds came out.
Who was it that we were talking to that said that they that Paul McCartney and Lennon had just dropped a new album and they came over and they wanted to hear it? Somebody here in the last 6-8 months talked about how much rivalry there was. There was respect,
right?
But there was a lot of rivalry for who had the latest cut and who wanted to listen to it. And I was just surprised at how open the Beatles had been to letting them come over, drop them the music, and then they were gone and off writing again.
Exactly. You know, there's a little story, I think, that Brian Wilson and Paul McCartney and I think it was George Harrison were at this Guru thing, you know, when they were into the Guru thing.
Right.
And McCartney was yakking with Brian Wilson quite a bit. And when after they left it, Paul wrote Back in the USSR, which has a Beach Boy flavor to it.
Oh, it does. Yeah,
definitely.
More so than Beatles. Of course, it became part of the Beatles repertoire, but
mm-hmm.
one of my favorite songs.
Yeah, I like Back in the USSR. It's absolutely.
Just interesting how not only the Beach Boys, but Brian Wilson in particular keeps coming back.
Yeah, and you know, it's nice to see him back on the, you know, out there doing shows.
Yeah, he's on tour again.
Because back in the days of the heights of the Beach Boy popularity, he kind of refrained from going on tour. And was staying in L.A. writing and producing, and he actually sent out other guys in his place, well, guys like Glenn Campbell, and who else played with the Beach Boys that was quite famous. But there was I think John Stamos actually
he drummed.
He
with
was
them.
The drummer, the touring Beach Boys in the '80s.
Yeah, that's
in the '90s as well, I think. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he had quite a run.
Yes, absolutely. So. Yeah, Brian Wilson, fascinating guy. And I might even read that book when you're done with it, Brad.
I will let you read it. It'll be finished here in a few days.
Absolutely. So what's going on? We got the Tacoma Wedding Expo, March 25th and 26th.
Yep, information at bridesclub.com.
Bridesclub.com. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, I'm the owner of Viva Productions. We have wedding DJ, wedding photography, And I also own Vegas Nights, which is casino entertainment. So 206-542-5733. And next
website?
Week, viva-productions.com. And hopefully next week, it's like 95% chance that Larry Thomas, the Soup Nazi, will be on our show. Viva
That'll be fun.
If that's not going to be a kick in the head, I don't know what will be, for sure. So, once again, ladies and gentlemen, you've been listening to Viva A&T, another great show, another fascinating guest. Thank you, Brad.
Thank you,
Eric. Always a pleasure to be on the show with you. Is this hurt?
This is hurt.
The live version. Live version.
Yes, indeed. All right, we're going to leave it with another one of our guests today's favorite Elvis Presley songs.
Yeah.
To think that you lied to me. I am hurt way down deep inside of me. You said our love was true, and we never, never part. Now you found someone new, and it breaks my heart. I'm hurt much more than you'll ever know. Yes, darling.
Dr. Amanda Wong and the team at Art of the Smiles provides comprehensive dental services at affordable prices. Their convenient location in Federal Way and their extended hours fits the needs of both families and working professionals. Whether it's transforming your smile through some of their cosmetic therapies or simply having your teeth cleaned, Art of the Smiles provides individualized care plans that address your priorities and needs. Visit artofthesmiles.com or call 253-839-4048. That's 253-839-4048 for same-day scheduling. Most insurances accepted, from cosmetic procedures to implant placement, molar root canals treatment, or wisdom teeth extractions.
Clay Radio, your conversation station. KLAY Lakewood Tacoma on 1180 AM.